नमस्ते स्टूडेंट्स। सो फर्स्ट वी विल सी कंप्यूटर साइंस चैप्टर वन फंडामेंटल्स ऑफ कंप्यूटर्स और ओवरव्यू ऑफ कंप्यूटर्स। सो लास्ट क्लास वी स्टडीड अबाउट अकॉर्डिंग टू देयर वर्किंग एंड अकॉर्डिंग टू देयर फंक्शनैलिटी देयर आर थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ कंप्यूटर्स, एनालॉग कंप्यूटर, डिजिटल कंप्यूटर एंड थर्ड वन इज हाइब्रिड कंप्यूटर। सो व्हाट डू यू मीन बाई एनालॉग कंप्यूटर? सी, एनालॉग कंप्यूटर मीन्स हियर इंफॉर्मेशन और सिग्नल्स इट इज कंटिन्यूअसली वेरिंग। That means it performs measuring rather than counting. So analog computer is, we can't get the accurate result or we can't get the limited value. And that means here information or signals are continuously varying. So it is a main thing or important facts about the analog computer. Second one is digital computer. So what do you mean by digital computer? As we know, digital computer uses the patterns of 1 and 0. Or voltage levels of 1 and 0. So voltage levels of 1 and 0 means here 0 indicates there is no voltage, 1 indicates there is a voltage. So these patterns of on and off or true and false, so that indicates some signals and it processes such signals and here we'll get the accurate value. And here accuracy in terms of unlimited accuracy, so we'll get a digital computer. And third one is hybrid computer. So what do you mean by hybrid computer? We know that analog computer means here informations are continuously varying. Example to analog computer is thermometer and to check the temperature, then some other voltmeter, speedometer, etc. So these are analog computer. Digital computer means just like what we can say, we are using microcomputer, laptops, desktop, etc. These are all digital computers. And third one is hybrid computer. See, hybrid computer means which combines the what we can say characteristics of both analog and digital. So what happens is hybrid computer is the combination of analog and digital computers. And one more thing is hybrid computer which gives the results, and that means which accesses information from the analog computer and it will process the information through digital computer. Okay, so here example to hybrid computer means in hospitals, intensive care unit, automated intensive care unit is the best example to the hybrid computer. Okay, these are about types of computers based on their functionality and their working. Next, we move on to this one, digital computer. See, under digital computer, there are four types: microcomputer, mini computer, mainframe, and last one is supercomputer. See, just go to this one. So what do you mean by microcomputer? See, microcomputer invented during, it means developed after 1970. It is developed after 1970 and it is also called PC. PC means personal computer, or we can say workstation, node, etc. So it is called as PC. And here under microcomputer, it may use one or two processors. And it contains input unit, output unit, storage, memory and processors. So it may use input unit like keyboard, mouse, joystick, etc. And output unit like printer and monitor, etc. And storage unit, it may use secondary storage, hard disk, floppy disk drive, CD-ROM, etc. Next, memory. So it uses some main memory, just like RAM, ROM, etc. And here main thing is it uses some processors. One or two processors it may use. Okay, these are about main thing. Microcomputer, or we can say PC. So next one is here under microcomputer, it can execute, or we can execute microcomputer. That means it allows only one user, or we can say single user. Single user can use microcomputer, not more than one user. That means it uses one keyboard, one mouse, monitor. So that's why single user can handle this one, microcomputer. An example to this one is microcomputer is Apple, Macintosh, etc. So Apple, Macintosh and some other computers like IBM, etc. Okay, so there are two types of microcomputers. First one is desktop computer. And then portable computer. Portable computer. See, desktop computer means we can place such computer on our tabletop, or also it is called tower computer. That means it includes some, you can say, monitors and CPU cabin or box and input devices like keyboard and then mouse, etc. So that's why it is called as desktop computer. And here also same processing power. That means it can execute some sort of instructions. And then second one is portable computer. So example jo portable computer is laptop. Here processing power of laptop and desktop are same. Processing power of laptop and desktop are same, and it is called portable means we can carry laptop, that means portable computer, from one place to another place, and it can occupy in our lab. So that means it's very portable, or that means it is very small compared to desktop computers, right? So it performs the same operation. So what are the operations performed by the desktop computer? So it is very important to study this one, laptop, portable computer. And under portable computer, another is the tablet PC. Tablet PC. So one of the examples to portable computers. So tablet PC and laptop. So microcomputer invention during 1970s. It is also called as PC. Two or more processors, one or two processors, and it contains input, output, storage, memory, and processors. And then single user, not more than one user. So if only one user can occupy that particular computer or engage that particular computer, so that's why it is called as single user. And example to this one is Apple Macintosh. And there are two types of microcomputers: desktop computers and portable computers. So it's very important for your examination purpose. You can expect this question for 5 marks. Explain the features of microcomputers. So here just we have to specify all those things, all the points, and then types of desktop computers or types of microcomputers also important. So you have to write these two things also. Next, move on to the next computer, that is mini computer. Mini computer invention during 1970s. And it is very large compared to microcomputer. It is very large and more powerful than microcomputer. See, microcomputer can occupy tabletop, but here it can occupy a building or a room. So that's why we can say it is large and more powerful, and it can execute 5 million of instructions per second. 5 million of instructions per second, or we can say MIPS. MIPS, full form of MIPS is millions of instructions per second. Millions of instructions per second. Naturally, your mini computers used by the small or medium scale industries. And here two or more processors. So mini computer uses two or more processors, and it can connect 4000 users simultaneously. And normally accessed by user, and it is accessed by the user. That means here that particular computer, we can say it is a mini computer, is connected to any other terminal. Many other terminal means it uses only input unit and display unit, and here there is no processing power, there is no processor or processing power. So we can handle all the information that are stored under this one mini computer. So we can handle that mini computer using these terminals. There is no independent processing power. So whatever the instruction, that will be accessed by this particular terminal, and this terminal is called as dumb terminal. Means there is no processing power, there is no processors, so it may use the processor from the mini computer itself. Okay, these are about mini computer. It can connect 4000 users simultaneously. That means simultaneously 4000 users can handle this computer, but in this case under microcomputer it is used by the single user.
And here normally accessed by the user, a device uses keyboard and monitor called terminal, and it is also called as dumb terminal without any processing power. Dumb terminal. And example to mini computer is WAX 8800 and AS 400. Okay, these are about mini computer. See once again, mini computer means 1960, invented during 1960, and it is larger and more powerful, and it can execute 5 millions of instructions per second. MIPS, 5 millions of instructions per second. Two or more processors here, and it can connect 4000 users simultaneously. Normally accessed by the user. User means we can say terminal, and in this case terminals having only input unit and output unit without any processing power or processors. And here a device uses keyboard and mouse called terminal, or it is also called as dumb terminal. And example to mini computers are WAX 8800 and AS 400. Okay, these are about mini computer, and it's very important to your examination also. Okay students, next one. So first one is microcomputer, second one mini computer, and third mainframe computers. And mainframe computers 1965, actually mainframe computer which solves trillions of instructions per second. And here under mainframe computers designed under 1965, it is very large computer in size, very large, and it is powerful than mini computer, and it is very large. And here multiple processors are used and designed to perform multiple tasks, or we can say multitasking. So multitasking, that means simultaneously we can execute more than one process or more than one task. It is called as multitasking, or sometimes we can say multi-programming also. And here multi-user, that means more than one user can execute, or it will serve, mainframe computer will serve more than one user. That means it can serve 50,000 users simultaneously. User can access through terminal or PC. Not needed to be the dumb terminal. Here, by using our computer itself, that means having some processing power, that means processors, we can access the values, or we can access the information from mainframe computers, not like mini computer. So what happens in mini computer? So under mini computer, it is connected to many terminals, and such terminals are called as dumb terminal, because that terminals having only input and output device without any processing power. But here we can connect our PC, means microcomputer, having some microprocessors. That means it can handle some sort of instructions. So such instructions or such computer is allowed in mainframe computers, not like mini computer. And here mainframe computer can execute 16 millions of instructions per second. It is about my mainframe computer. And example to mainframe computer is NEC 610 DEC 10. Okay, these are about mainframe computer. And uses of mainframe computers in big industries, in companies having more than 50,000 users, of 4,000 users, we can use mainframe computers. And mainframe computers mainly used in the internet also. That means in database applications also we can use mainframe computers. Suppose if you want to store the information about the citizens of India, here we need a big database. Here we can use mainframe computers. So we can connect mainframe computer to the internet also, so such that we can access the information through internet. It serves to the internet. So what are the instructions are stored under mainframe computers, that will be accessible in internet also. In case if you are going to, if it is
permission is provided, then only it is possible.
Okay, these are both mainframe computers. Mainframe computers introduced during 1965. It is very large computer in size, very large computer in size, and powerful than mini computer. So it is powerful than mini computer, and here it uses multiple processors, and it is designed to perform multiple tasks. That means multi-programming, or we can say multitasking. And here multi-user can be used. That means more than 50,000 users work simultaneously, or users can use this computer, mainframe computer, simultaneously. This is the main advantage of mainframe computer. And user can access through terminal or PC, not like mini computer. Here we can use PC. PC will be treated as a terminal with some processing unit or processor, and it is an importance of mainframe computer. Here mainframe computer can execute 16,000 million of instructions per second, 16,000 million of instructions per second. And example to mainframe computer is NEC 610 and BEC 10. Okay, these are about mainframe computers. Next, move on to the next concept, that is supercomputer. And here 1980, introduced during 1980, it is very fast, big in size, it can handle what we can say complex calculations, and it is used for the animation graphics field also, and many computers designed in India also. Param 2000, next ECA by Pune Institute of Tata Institution. Okay, these are about supercomputer. And some points about supercomputers are, it is very fastest computer and biggest in size. Supercomputers are biggest in size and sophisticated, complex and advanced computer. Supercomputers are sophisticated, complex and advanced computers. And supercomputer having large storage capacity. Large storage capacity and can process trillions of instructions per second. Trillions of instructions per second. TIPS. Trillions of instructions per second. But it is expensive. Supercomputers are expensive. Okay, once again here. Supercomputers designed during 1980. It is very fastest computer and biggest in size, and sophisticated, complex and advanced computer. See, supercomputers are sophisticated, complex and advanced computers, and large storage capacity, having large storage capacity, can process trillions of instructions per second, and it is expensive. And one more thing about supercomputer, it will occupy a room or a big building also. See, here many storage devices we need, and here what we can say main memory also. Compared to other computer, it is more than 1000 times, or sometimes it is more than 1,000,000 times also. And these are about supercomputer. And then uses of supercomputer, here first one is weather forecasting. We can predict the weather, with the help of supercomputers. And it is used in animated graphics in Hollywood movies. Not only Hollywood movies, nowadays available in India also, Indian movies also, we can implement animated movies by using supercomputers. And it is used in the field of fluid dynamic calculation. And fourth one is nuclear energy research. It is used in the nuclear energy research. And next one is space science. It is used in the space science. And one more thing is weapon and missile design. We can use supercomputers. Weapon and missile design. We can use supercomputer. And some latest what we can say emerging technology like artificial intelligence and cyber robotics. And these two fields can be improved by using the supercomputers. So supercomputers are used in weather forecasting,
integrated graphics, fluid dynamic calculation, and nuclear energy research, space science, weapon and missile design, and some supercomputers are example to supercomputer. It's very important. You can expect this question for final exam also. And Cray XP and ETA 10 and India EKA, EKA. It is one of the Tata institution in Pune, designed by Tata institution, and Param 2000. Okay, these are about supercomputers. And these four types of computers, like microcomputer, mini computer, and mainframe computer, and supercomputers, are very important for your examination purpose. They can ask any one of these four types, and it is for 4 marks or 5 marks. Okay, students, next move on to the applications of computers. So far we studied about four types of computers: mini computer, microcomputer, mainframe computers, and supercomputers. And some applications of computers in real world. So what are the usage of computers in the different fields? Here, first one is schools and colleges. So we can use computers in schools and colleges. So what are the softwares that we can use in schools and colleges? See, softwares like you can use MS Office or Microsoft Office or office automation tools that we can use under, I mean, schools and colleges, and some databases also to store the information of each and every students, their address, and we can say their general, their marks in different subjects, and total marks in each and every examination, and all those things can be stored here. And the database means here it's a collection of, we can say, information, logical related information. So schools and colleges, we can use office automation tools, and we can use office automation tools means we can use text editor, that means to prepare timetable, to write in notes, or we can say we can use a presentation software also to give online coaching classes, or we can use Excel, or we can say spreadsheet applications here. That means in schools and colleges. Next one is banks. In banks, we can use computers to store all the transactions, daily transaction, monthly, weekly, etc. And here we can, to perform some calculation also, we can use some softwares in banks. Okay. Next, under office. In office, there are some softwares like Microsoft Office softwares, Microsoft Word, Excel, and then PowerPoint, etc. These are used under office. Okay. Next one is stock control in business firms. Stock control in business firms. So we can control the stocks by using the computer itself. That means online transaction also allowed. Suppose if you want to sell your shares in the stock exchange, so we can make use of softwares. And here also under stock exchange. Next, research and development field. See, computers are used under research and development field, and it is very important. So to calculate scientific calculations, to calculate or to design some automation, or to design some, what we can say, missiles, scientific machines. So these are all, that means a 3D design also allowed here. So these are application of computer under the field of research and development. Next, entertainment and news. In movies, in serials, so we can make use of this one, computers. That means we can implement CG. CG means computer graphics. Computer graphics can be implemented here, entertainment, and under news also. News, while we are watching movies, you'll get the information. So how we can present a news clip on the TV. So all those things can be performed by the computer. Next one is government office. Under government office also we can make use of this one, computers. That means to get the information from the central, to get the information from the state government, central government, etc. So we need this one, computers and the government offices. So next one is satellite communication. satellite communication through the microwave tower, from microwave tower to telephone exchange, telephone exchange to independent houses or individual houses, individual connections, etc.
So we can make use of this one, computers.
See, nowadays we are using mobiles, that is because of the application of computer. How we can transfer the information from one mobile to another, or one workstation to another workstation. So these are all designed under computer.
So without computer, we can't get or we can't perform the communication, right?
Next one is publishing, and in press or in online,
we need this one, application of computers. That means under publishing, we need DTP software, desktop publishing.
Desktop publishing is one of the softwares that is to set our page according to the space. According to the space, okay, these are about
what we can say application of computers under publishing.
Next one is travel. See, suppose if you want to book some tickets, it may be air ticket, railway ticket, so we need computers. See, actually we are using internet. Even though we are using internet, we need computer to send some information through the internet.
So under travel also we need computer.
Next,
computer aided manufacturing, or we can say CAM, computer aided manufacturing.
That means using the computer we can perform or we can design some manufacturing unit.
And here we need CAD, computer aided design.
Computer aided design,
we need CAD, computer aided design.
So computer helps us to design our own applications or design our own ideas, etc.
Okay, these are about computer aided manufacturing. It is one of the advantage or use of or application of computers.
Next one is under hospitals also we need computers. That is to keep track of details of all patients, it may be inpatient or outpatient, to keep a track of automated ICU unit, intensive care unit.
Okay, these are all come under this one, hospitals. So these are applications of computers. So this one is very important. You can expect this question for 5 marks.
Okay, there are some important questions. One more questions under this chapter.
Expand MIPS. MIPS means millions of instructions per second. And EDVAC. And fourth one is ENIAC. See, EDVAC means electronic discrete variable automatic computer. UNIVAC means universal automatic computer. ENIAC means electronic numerical integrator and calculator, or automated calculator. Okay, these are all very important expansions. So you can expect this question for final exam also. And basic components of first generation computer. So what are the basic components of first generation computer? So here, vacuum tubes, basic components of first generation computer, vacuum tubes. And second, transistors. Third, ICs. And fourth, here ICs we can say LSI, large scale integration. And fourth generation computer, very large scale integration. And fifth generation computer, ultra large scale integration. Okay, these are all very important. And along this video link, I'll give some worksheet according to this chapter. And please prepare the worksheet properly and submit it in time. And next, I'm going to present another chapter, that is software concept. We'll see in next class.